What defines us? Is it our job? Our family? Is it our nationality? Well, for young woman Hayden Sparks, it was a number on a scale.
Hi, my name is Hayden Sparks. I am 18 years old, and I've been attending Dream City Church now for 18 years. I was raised in the church with my family and my two older sisters. And it's really that foundation of faith that's pulled me through these last couple years. Coming on about 2 years now, 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with an eating disorder. And that was something that was a spiritual journey for me and for my family. It was quite the event trying to find doctors to work with, just kind of as I became less of myself and more obsessed with what I looked like, not my personality, not my faith, not my friends, but just physically what I looked like and what I was doing, I became more and more unhealthy. And as we went on this journey together to try to find doctors that could help me mentally and physically, I quickly saw that doctors really strive to treat the symptom, not the cause. And for me, it was a heart issue and it was a spiritual battle. And I'm so grateful for my faith because it gave me the boldness to say to those doctors, you know, when they would tell me, we have this meal plan for you, or this is the approach we're going to take, and anorexia is something you're going to struggle with your whole life. You're never going to be healed from it. I looked those doctors in the eyes and I said to them, that's a lie. And I believe in a God that heals, and that heals in full, not in part. And if you're not willing to accept that, I'm not willing to work with you. And because of that boldness and that step of faith, my family had more trust in me, and the church trusted me. I was able to work close with them and really lean into God to be my strength and to pull me through those moments of insecurity and those moments of weakness, and rely on Him to show me the truths about myself, what His word said about me, not rely on the validation from the world or what I saw in the mirror, what I saw on the scale. And so there came a point in my journey where I was so beaten down and tired from just fighting those battles in my mind, fighting against the enemy. And I cried out to God and I just wrote to Him and I said, God, I know you have a plan for this and a purpose for this, and I'm not sure why I'm feeling this pain, but like, how much longer do I have to suffer? And it was that night that He woke me up from a dead sleep with the verse Mark 5:34 in my head. And as strong of a Christian as I was, like, I didn't know what the verse said, and I went and I looked it up, and the verse verbatim reads, daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering. And it was in that moment that I took that sign from God and that clear answer and said, okay, I fully trust you. I fully commit to believing what you say, and I'm willing to put in the work to retrain my thoughts and, you know, trust in what you're calling me to be and the woman that you've created me to be. And from that point on, it's been a tough journey, you know, accepting that life is hard, but I've really been able to embrace who I am in God and share my struggles with other people. And I was given the opportunity to share my story at the Fight Like a Girl conference, and just touched my heart to be able to inspire so many other young women and help them come out of this health issue and this disorder that the world puts on them that they don't have to deal with, that God can heal you from that, and you are beautifully and wonderfully made. And so that's just my story, and I, as painful as it was, I'm forever thankful for it and can't wait to see what God keeps doing through me.
Well, I have with me today Hayden Sparks. Hayden, I love your story because it's a story that relates to thousands of men and women in America today. And I just want to know, how did the eating disorder begin?
So for me, the eating disorder definitely stemmed from a confidence issue and some struggles that I had with body image just from a young age. But what really catapulted it was at the end of my freshman year, I decided to go on a diet. And although it seemed like the right thing to do at the time, it really put me in this unhealthy environment where I was obsessed with what I was eating, how much I was eating, how much I was exercising, and it just kind of spun out of control for me.
Absolutely, and it seems like in America today that diet culture is climaxing. It's everywhere, counting your macros, vegan. Everybody's encouraged to go on a diet. Do you think that's feeding into eating disorders in America today?
100%, I think it is. I think it's honestly the cause of most eating disorders, especially in young high school age girls. For me, on social media, it created such an atmosphere for comparison. I wasn't just focused on my personal progress or how I felt in my own body, but I was comparing myself to what everybody else looked like and what everybody else was eating.
Right. So what did the healing process look like for you?
So for me, the healing process was very different than I think any clinical eating disorder healing process looks like, which I am so grateful for. It was one that was done, you know, at home with the backing and support of my family and leaning upon all of our relationships with the Lord. And it was one where we made it our goal to overcome my challenges and my fears together. My family was right there supporting me, and it was centered around waking up early in the morning, you know, getting in the Word, doing my devotionals, and setting my mind to be in the right position to take those thoughts captive and combat those negative thoughts that tried to come in and stop my progress. We really focused, too, on, you know, overcoming challenges instead of avoiding them. In a lot of inpatient facilities that people go into, there's such an emphasis on nobody look at anybody else's plate and just worry about, you know, your personal health, and we're not gonna let you see your weight. But at home, I was like focused on overcoming that. I didn't want to worry about being in a social setting and not being able to look at someone else's plate or not being able to deal emotionally with a number on the scale, because ultimately a number doesn't define who I am at all.
Right. So how are you using your story to inspire other men and women today?
Well, I'm continuing to just share my story any chance that I get. You know, it's an amazing thing to be able to glorify God for the miraculous way He transformed my life and that He was my strength, championing me through all of my struggles. And so I had the amazing opportunity of sharing it at your conference, Fight Like a Girl. It was such just an out of this world opportunity that I didn't expect to have. And I also try to share it through social media. I have a small company called Shine Co. And you know, I like to spread the message that good food fuels good people, and that's the backing for my company.
You are absolutely incredible. And how old are you?
18.
18, you're an entrepreneur, you're an overcomer. You're just amazing, Hayden. Well, Hayden Sparks has had an amazing support group through our church, Dream City Church. If you need a support group, find a church. And if you want a church to look into, check out dreamcitychurch.us.